Aloha and welcome back to YAMA Studios. My name is Hannah Maruyama. I am a scalp micropigmentation practitioner and hair loss coach at YAMA Studios, which is a scalp micropigmentation and paramedical tattoo clinic in Honolulu, Hawaii. Today, I'm going to be answering one of the most frequently asked questions that we get at the studio about hair loss. Now, before we get into today's topic, I do want to welcome the subscribers back to the channel. Thank you so much for watching. And then if you're new here, welcome to you as well. Please feel free to like and subscribe so you don't miss any of our videos. Our guide and our books are linked below. If anything here spikes your interest and you do need some resources or guidance on how to look into those things for yourself. Now, let's get into today's topic. Now, today's topic is, will hair loss from stress grow back? This is a really good question. One thing that I do recommend when folks come in and ask if stress-related hair loss is going to grow back is I do tell them to go and speak to their doctor. This is really important because you do need to bring a health professional in, especially if your stress is having a physical manifestation, especially one like hair loss, which can really cause even more stress and even more trauma. As somebody who sees a lot of folks that are dealing with this, it's very important to go to your doctor with this. Even though it doesn't seem like a health problem, it actually is, and you do need to speak to a health professional about this. Now, whether or not hair can grow back from stress-related hair loss, it's a complicated question, so the answer is kind of complicated as well. And that is, for women, sometimes stress-related hair loss, or TE, can actually kind of unmask other types of chronic hair loss, and so it really just depends. And that's a huge part of the reason you need to talk to a doctor about it, because they are going to be able to tell you what's going on, and then they'll be able to point you in the direction of a specialist if they need to look at your hair follicles and see if they're actually miniaturizing, or see what's going on with your scalp so they can identify whether or not it's something that they can treat. And that's actually a huge thing here, is you really need to go talk to a health professional if you believe that your hair loss is stress induced. Now, for men, it's slightly different. Still though, you should talk to a doctor about this, but for men, hair loss can be more genetic. And so for them, it's a little bit different in that for women, if you're noticing severe hair loss due to stress, that's something that is going to be treated differently than a man who's going through hair loss, because the genetics are different and the hormones are different as well. So the root cause of it can sometimes be separate. And so that's why you do need to go to a doctor and talk to them about this, because they're going to have to help you weed through the cause and then figure out the best solution for you too. Now, in the interim, because I realize that saying go talk to a doctor is not the most actionable thing in the world, while it is the best advice I can give you, and this is not going to sound fun either, but reducing stress in any way that you can. And by that, I mean finding ways in your daily routine to create a little bit more order, a little bit more peace. I realize that for a lot of folks, that doesn't always seem possible, but even taking small 30-second breaks to just take a breath, breathe a little bit, and just try to lower your heart rate and try to get some sort of sense of just stillness and calm for a moment, can help to recenter you. Another thing to note is that when you are losing your hair, it can actually cause you more stress. So trying not to dwell on every little bit of the hair loss, because sometimes I've noticed that a lot of folks that come in, and if they believe that they're experiencing stress-related hair loss, they're actually stressing themselves out more by trying to fix their hair loss by fixing stress. Now, that may seem a little bit redundant since I just recommended trying to reduce stress, but the point of this is you can't fixate on your hair loss, because it will sometimes just add a whole nother level of stress. And so what you really need to do is just focus on your core health instead of the health of your hair, because sometimes it's the core health that's affecting the health of your hair. And to identify what the root cause is, you do need to go to your doctor. In the meantime, try not to dwell on it and obsess about it, because it can actually add more and make it worse. And so while I realize that that's a difficult thing to do, sometimes just acknowledging that that can happen will help to mitigate the amount of stress that you pile on yourself because of your hair loss. So I realize that this probably wasn't the most actionable video in the world, but I do think it's really important, because a lot of people feel like they have to scramble when they realize or they feel that stress is causing their hair loss. It often causes them to feel even more stressed out. And so having an actual plan, which is, okay, I'm going to go talk to a professional, and then I'm not going to dwell on this because it's going to make it worse. And that can sometimes help a little bit. And I do believe that that just having that knowledge can help empower you to act and also to feel more in control of the situation, which can help reduce stress in turn. So I realize this was kind of a long answer for a simple question, but I do think that it's important and I do want to answer it just because we get asked that question so often. So thank you so much for watching. Do appreciate your time. Like and subscribe if you don't want to miss any more videos. And if you have questions or you need a recommendation, do feel free to reach out to us. We're happy to point you in the direction of resources, or if you're looking for scalp micropigmentation, we can direct you to a scalp micropigmentation provider as well. All right. On behalf of the YAMA Studios team and myself, thank you so much for watching.